हेलो हेलो
हेलो।
यार, द ओनली टू गाइज आर देयर। द वन इज सुबह शुभम, अदर वन इज सुधांशु। यार वी स्टार्ट नाउ। ओके, वी
यस
आर
श्योर।
स्टार्टिंग। ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम। सो द सुधांशु, आर यू देयर? Yeah, Mr. Sudhanshu, are you there? Okay, no problem. So please turn on your camera also. Sudhanshu, turn on your camera. In last class, we have done the starting introduction of cloud computing. Okay? So what is cloud computing basically? If the we'll discuss about definition of cloud computing. You are in classroom or somewhere else, some other place? Sudhanshu, where are you? In classroom? At your room? Okay, nice. So what is cloud computing? We'll discuss about it. So in last class, have you have any doubt? Yesterday we have discussed about any doubt? No, the participate of storing, if we'll discuss about cloud computing definition in a layman language, if you have database. I'm audible? Siddhanshu, that's okay. So the practice of storing regular use computer data on multiple servers that can be accessed through the internet. So if you have a data in your local machine and you want to access through the network, Chudanshu, are you busy somewhere else? Some other place? That's okay. So I think you don't have doubt out and what is cloud computing? Next, we have done the introduction of cloud computing, the cloud computing models, evolution of cloud computing models we have done, and just we will discuss about evolution of cloud computing and cloud business also. The next is desktop computing. We have done yesterday desktop computing. I will let you know about it today also. Cloud server computing, cluster computing, grid computing, cloud computing. Next, so what is desktop computing? Yesterday I told you about it. Yes, Subham. Any doubt? So, Sudhanshu, you also know about it? Yes, no problem. Desktop computing, personal computer, professionals, and office desktop softwares we use in a desktop computing: MS Office, AutoCAD, Photoshop, Illustrator, 3D Audio Studio, and Studio Max, Dreamweaver, Visual Studio, and NetBeans. Okay, so any doubt in this slide? I think no. No. Sudhanshu, you have? No, that's okay. Now this client server model, I have discussed about it also yesterday. If there is a one machine that is server and other machines are clients, these machines are connecting with this servers and all these machines are using the compute of this server. So here we have a RAM, storage, and CPU. Okay, and these are the client machines which are using the compute power of this server. Yesterday I told you about the client server model. There are two type of client server environment. So the one is a dedicated server is there. Other one is standalone, dedicated. You can say that. Dedicated server is the server where every machine connect. The clients don't have their compute power. Okay. The next is here we have printer. This is the storage printer also. This is the backup unit where we store the backup of the server. Okay, and this is the BlackBerry fan which is connected with this laptop through laptop, and just we are connecting this machine with the server. Here we have database server, and these are the desktop applications. Two desktop applications are there, and this is the database server. The machine and the users are using database from this server. In this client server network, this is called the client server computing. Two types of servers are there. If you will discuss about network, this one is the server based network, other one is the peer to peer. In server based network, the every machine is connected with the server, and in peer to peer network, every machine is itself a server. No machine is server, no machine is client. So they have their login ID, they have their local database, they have their local user account. Means we have like these machines. If we connect these machines in a peer-to-peer network, in every machine we have a local user account, and these machines will log in through the local user account. If we discuss about the domain controller or the server-based network, we have to create user account in this server, and we will share all the credentials to the users which are connected in the network, so they can log in and they can work with the network. So I think this is clear. Any doubt in this? Sudhanshu, any doubt in this? Sudhanshu, Gulshan, good. Where are you? Where is Diksha? Here only, that's good. Where is Diksha? Okay, continue karte hain. That's okay. Client server computing, we discuss about client server computing. The softwares are like accounting, finance, and sales ERP, and CRM, and distribution ERP, and manufacturing ERP, and the SAP, Oracle apps. So we use this model in banks, we use this model in retail store, we use this marketing sales, distribution, aviation companies, automobile companies, oil companies. So this was the client server computing environment where we used. If you'll go to the bank, you will find it. If you'll go to the retail store, you will find it. If you'll go to the marketing sales like Big Bazaar and other places, you will get it. Distribution, if you will go to the sugar mills, there you can find this type of network, client server module, client server computing. Okay, the client server, you know, just yesterday I told you about it. If you will discuss about client server model, in this one machine is server and other machines are clients. So we have to, when we are planning for the network, we have to decide the compute power of the server to connect host machines with it. So for example, yesterday I've given you example. If we have a server with the compute power of 2 gigahertz CPU and 4 GB of RAM and 20 GB of storage. Okay. So for example, just we can connect with this server only 20 hosts. If we'll connect more than 20 hosts, then load will increase on this server, and the server will be, it may be, it will heat up, it will hang, it will give you the data delay, latency time will increase. So many things will create problem in a network. So we have to enhance the compute power of this server. Got it? Sudhanshu, yes. Okay, next is the cluster computing. Yesterday I told you about it. If we have a network in my company where we have single server and 50 client machines are connected with this server. My boss ordered me that we want 100 client machines in my office. So what I will do, just I will connect 100 machines with this same server. So what will happen, this machine, this server will hang up, it may be because the compute power is the same, but the clients increased. So what will happen, the load will increase when we connect 100 computers with a server which can manage only 50 machines. So we need to increase the compute power. Got it? So more clients, if you have more clients, more load on server. Next. Here we have a simple model. Just we want to discuss about cluster computing, how we can go for the cluster. The one way is that in this network environment, I will remove this server from here, this server. Okay, and this server capacity is 2.0 gigahertz CPU, 4 GB of RAM, 20 GB of storage. What I will do, if I want to connect more than 50 computers, that means my boss ordered me to do the double of the number of clients are there in present condition. So 100 clients we need to connect. What I will do, just I will remove this server from here and I will purchase a new server with double compute power. The 4 gigahertz of CPU, 8 GB of RAM and 40 GB of storage. The one thing is that. So if I will remove this server from here, this server will be useless for us. We'll go for the new. This is the wastage for the company. Got it? Getting? So for that, what can I do? Two options are there. One, I will purchase a new server of double configuration, or the second option, I will purchase a new server with the same configuration. And what I will do, I will go with clustering for both servers. Okay, so this is here we have first server, and I will purchase another server of the same configuration. The costing of this server will be lowest than the higher configuration machine, and the wastage of the machine will, there is no wastage because this machine also work in the network. Got it? Okay, but there is a condition. If you want to go for the clustering, there is a condition. What condition is there? For the clustering, you need a server at the second server with the same configuration. For example, in the first server, which is old server in your organization, the configuration of this server is ABC hardware. For example, the motherboard is Intel chipset, and there is a LAN card is Realtek 8139 Wi-Fi. The configuration, that means motherboard configuration should be same. ABC operating system should be same. Like if we have here 2010 server, so we have to install here 2010 also. If the ABC application is there, if SAP 1.20 version is there, just we need to install SAP 1.20 version. ABC, you can say this is the example only. ABC hardware, the name of the hardware, you can say that. Hardware ABC CPU, RAM, storage, motherboard, ABC like this. Got it, Gulshan? So I didn't name mention here like motherboard, storage, RAM, CPU, ABC. It means these, you can say these are the parts. For example, here we have in this server one, here we have ABC hardware. So we need ABC hardware for the second server also. Got it? Yeah, same devices we required. The configuration should be same. If the configuration will be different, we cannot go for the clustering. That is not possible. Clustering is not possible. Got it? So the operating system should be same. For example, if we have server 2008 in server 1. Yes, one question. Yes, yes.
Hello, sir.
Yes, yes.
One thing, and this mean and that's mean cluster working only for the same services, same configuration.
Yes, same servers. Yeah.
Any configuration will be same.
Yeah, configuration will be same. Hardware configuration will be same. Operating system will be same. ABC application will be same.
If configuration is not same, so what?
You cannot go with the clustering. You cannot connect to. You cannot do the clustering with between different configuration machines, different configuration servers. You cannot do.
Okay.
So we call these are homogeneous server. What are these? These are homogeneous servers because the configuration of both servers are same. So here we have two servers only. If in future my boss, after 2 or 3 years, he told me that just you need to add 100 machines more. What I will do? Just I will remove these two machines and then I will go once again for the new server, or I will purchase one more server with same configuration and I will add this server with this network as a cluster server. That is cheapest way. Got it? So what, how much with the compute power, this machine and third machine also work like a single server. If we connect 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 100, 200, 400, 500, 1000. If you discuss about Tata network, Tata cloud, what they have done, they have the cluster servers also. Yes, because the same configuration, that's why homogeneous. Yes, got it. Gulshan, where are you? Just I cannot see you. Where are you? Okay. Hi. So this is I think today's you are also late, no? You joined late. No problem. So I think everything is clear. No problem. But everything is clear now. Clustering, cluster computing. So before cloud, we will discuss everything. What is desktop? What is grid? What is cluster? Everything. Okay. So this is cluster computing. We have a single server. If we need to add more clients, so we are adding some more load. So we need more compute power. What we can do, just we can add a server with the same configuration of the old server, same, and just continuously we can do this. What we will do with these servers, we will add these servers as a cluster, that is called cluster computing. So these are the data center servers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. These two server works as one server. Yes. Yes, please. Gulshan. Yes. What question? Unmute you. Okay. You can type Gulshan here. What question you have? Long question. Type single word, I will understand. I will let you answer, long answer you will get. Gulshan is typing one question. He have one question. So wait for he have its question is very long. He is typing. If we have different type of servers and we want to cluster for them to interact with each other, then I will let you know about it. The question is correct. If we have two or more than servers, the configuration of these servers are not same. In basic terms, we cannot add these servers. These are the different application servers. You are saying that these are the different servers. What I'm saying about data center server. Just read it. Here we have data center server. The DHCP server playing different role. Mail server is playing different role. HTTP servers are playing different role. If you have email server, that means email server. If you have data center server, in data center server, they have these type of servers. Yeah. But they will use same configuration. They will use same OS. They will use same application. If we discuss about Google, web server is there. Okay, try to understand. Okay, so just I start my Google server. I have given the access to 100 host. So as the time is going on, the host continuously increasing day by day. So the everyone is connecting with that internet. So what they are doing, they are searching Google. If they send request to the Google server, if we'll discuss about in 1992, so there was lakhs of users are there who use the Google, but nowadays in 2019, you can understand that every user is using Google now. Just every time they put www.google.com, hits goes to the server, Google server. Most probably, not only for the data center servers, most probably, if the application is there, for example, one application I provided to the clients in my network, okay? So my network is there, I provided one application. Okay, so the users will use this application in a particular area. If we increase this network, the users will increase. That means host machines will increase, the load will increase. So we need more compute power. So we have only one option: to remove old one and place new one. Or the second option, we add one more the same configuration machine in this network. This will reduce the cost of the network. Cluster compute work only for the data center. Got it? Not only for the data center server. This is the example. Yes. Okay. So homogeneous is clear? Yes. Everyone? Yes, yes, that's okay. Now the next one is the cluster computing. If we have just, you can see this picture. So this is the server room basically. When 50 host, they started from the 50 host. So the company increasing their clients. So they add one more server. And these are the servers. These are the multiple servers working like a single server machine. These are the multiple switches. Multiple switches are there. Multiple servers are there, which are connected through these switches. And this is the cluster computing environment. So the, if you want to increase the compute power of a single machine, that is not possible to purchase a processor of 300 gigahertz speed. But if you will go with the clustering, it is possible you can increase the compute power to provide accessing to the client machines. Got it? So if as load increase, you add one more server in a cluster. We can go through one server to another. I'm not getting. I'm not getting your question. From one server to another server, where we can go? This is the my company. Basically, this is the network. I'm using cluster computing for my company. Okay. From one server to another server to access the server. No. These servers will work like a single server for the host machine. For the system admin, only one machine. Yes. If all host machines, all client users, if they will open their machine, they will find single machine, ABC. But here, at the back end, 500 machines are working. Got it? They can see only single machine, the name of ABC server. But here we have multiple servers in at back end. Only one. But in back end, it can be 1,000 machines are there. It can be 2,000 machines are there. Server rooms, AC environment, racks are there, continuously heat generating, SMPS is there. So for the computing, we need SMPS, power supply, we need storage, okay? We need compute power, CPU, we need RAM. Got it, Gulshan? So means here we have these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 40 machines. These are 40 machines. Okay. Here we have power supply for these 40 machines. This is the rack unit which is connected. Switch or hubs are there. Routers are there. And all these are machines connected like last picture. You can say that. Here we have a device where we connect these machines for the load balancing. And here we have cluster environment. This is cluster environment. So this is called cluster computing. Got it? This is basic networking. If you don't know about it, it can create a problem. Sudhanshu, Gulshan. Sudhanshu, yes. Gulshan. Subham. You confused? Okay.
No.
Okay, no problem. So the next, grid computing. There are multiple companies. So the one company which is in Delhi, the another company is Bangalore, another one is in Noida, another one is in different states are there, and different companies branches are there. So when we start in Delhi, we used a server with the configuration of 2 gigahertz RAM, 4 GB of RAM, 2 gigahertz CPU, 4 GB of RAM, and 20 GB of hard disk. Okay. When we started in Bangalore, we start for this network with 4 gigahertz of RAM, CPU, and 8 GB of RAM and 80 GB of hard disk. Okay. So these machines are connected in different configuration server environment. Here we have different configuration in Delhi office. Here we have different configuration in Bangalore office. Got it? Sir, do we use SMPS for securing the network? Gulshan, SMPS is nothing more than a power supply unit. SMPS is only the power supply unit. It's not a part of networking. Switch mode power supply. If you know any other device by which we can provide power to the computer, tell me. Switch mode power supply. Why we say this is switch mode power supply, SMPS? Because in SMPS we have two types of current values. They have many ports. No. Yes, these are the options. If you want to connect more devices, just you can connect. No. They have many ports in switch. For what? What kind of ports? To provide power supply to hard disk, to motherboard, to CD-ROM. Or any other option you know, just tell me, Gulshan. Many ports in switches. Why only SMPS? What question you are putting, I'm not getting. I study about bridge something. What is bridge? This is the basic part of the networking. I'll let you know, Gulshan. Whenever we are going to start networking, we should have idea if two machines are connected to each other and these two machines can share data between them. So that is networking in two machines. If you want to connect more than two machines, you need hub. Hub is a device which can transfer data as it is to other machines. Hub cannot amplify the signals. Hub cannot filter the signals. Okay. Hub, there is no port address in hub. You cannot define. I'm studied about. Please unmute me. Okay. Just a moment. Yes, Gulshan. Speak. Your voice is not. Check your mic, please. Check your mic, please. Hello. Shubham Gupta.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, your mic is working. Gulshan, your mic is not working. Sudhanshu.
Yes, sir.
Sudhanshu's mic is working. What about Gulshan, your mic? Yes, hello, Sudhanshu, your mic is not working. Nobody can.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
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 Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Gulshan, your voice is not okay. Drop message, I think, you know, your voice is not okay. Check your mic and change it. Please change it. If possible, take new one. Should I wait? Shubham Gupta's voice is okay. Sudhanshu's voice is okay. But Gulshan, your mic is not working. No. Only your mic is not working. Type here, please. Type in chat. No, voice is not there. Should we continue or wait for your... Are you checking mic? Gulshan, type yes or no so that I can start. Voice, your mic is not working, dear. You can type your question, no problem. Tomorrow just you should check your mic also before class. Technical issue, no problem. That's okay. You can type your question, no problem. If we'll discuss about SMPS, SMPS is a power supply unit which is required to provide power to the server or the computer. Okay? So, without power supply, machine cannot work. Your question is like this, why only SMPS? Switch mode power supply. This is different thing. You are talking about switch. Switch is different thing. Networking device, if we'll discuss about networking device, the first is hub, switch, manageable switch, network switch, router, router, bridges, firewall. I am asking that we provide power using SMPS, but something else instead of it. Okay, to provide power supply, something else instead of it. To powers HMPS. what is HMPS? Subham?
SMPS, I don't know HMPS.
Sudhanshu?
No, sir, I don't know about it.
You know. Gulshan, what is the full form of SMPS? That is adapter. That is adapter. So that is, yeah, that's okay. And what about if this is SHMPS, hub mode power supply, and SMPS, that means switch mode power supply. So what's okay. So hub mode power supply, where we use hub mode power supply, the hub mode power supply, if we want to provide power supply to different machines, if we have 10 machines and we want to use single power supply for all, okay, so there are multiple ports. Got it? Through it we can provide 10 servers are there, okay, and we have HMPS. Gulshan, you want to say that? That's why I was asking. Yes. But we'll discuss about later, no problem. And you know, that's if we are connecting servers, one server to another server, and this will become a cluster or this will become a grid. Like same, we can discuss about it. The power supply, if we have a single power supply unit, so we don't require multiple SMPS for multiple servers. Got it? Subham. He's right at his end. Huh? No problem. Okay, Gulshan, you are right. No problem. Now we are discussing about grid computing. Okay, we should continue now. Gulshan, yes, okay. Server on different locations with different configurations. Okay, here we have one server in Delhi, other server is in Bangalore, other server is in Maharashtra, Mumbai, other server is in Hyderabad. All these servers are working in different configuration environment. But now I want to connect all these network together. Okay, so what I will do, just I want to connect these servers together in a single computing environment. Got it? In different configuration machines. Like if you have like this, for example, here we have different configuration machine. These are the same configuration machines in a same location, but in grid, different configuration machines in different locations. Got it, Gulshan? Subham? Sudhanshu? Okay. In cluster computing, same configuration machines in same location. In grid computing, we use where the servers on different locations with different configurations. Clear? And we want to share the load balancing of these configuration servers, which are in different locations. For example, the compute power of this server is higher than this. If we connect these machines together, what will happen? This machine will handle all the load of these machines. If the limit will cross the load, bearing the load of this machine, this will transfer the load to the other machine, which is in Bangalore. Got it? I am saying here we have high configuration server. Here we have low configuration server. This server can manage 1000 clients. This server can manage only 100 clients. If we connect more than 100 clients here, what this server will transfer the load? This server will transfer the load to the Bangalore office. Got it? So you can say that in grid computing, the different configurations machines are connected to each other. And these machines will work like a single machine. Got it? For example, we have Google server. When you search Google, you type www.google.com. Sometime you type www.google.co.in. Sometime you can type www.google.co.us. Sometime you can type www.google.co.au. So that means we have everywhere Google server. Got it? So that means we have also Indian Google server. Any doubt? Yes, Gulshan. Just open your browser. You have doubt or no? Gulshan? Yes or no? No doubt. What about Sudhanshu? Sudhanshu, where are you? Got it. Okay, no problem. So just we continue it. Grid computing, that is heterogeneous server. Clustering, homogeneous. Grid computing, heterogeneous. Heterogeneous servers. Different operating systems. It may be the machine which is in Noida, they are using Red Hat. It may be this machine which is in Gurgaon, they are using Windows Server 2008. The machine which is in Delhi, they are using Windows Server 2012. Here we have this machine that they are using Red Hat version 2.3. That means different operating system. All these machines are using different operating system, application system. Different application servers, like your questions answer here, Gulshan. This is DHCP server, this is DNS server, this is email server, this is different servers are there. Database server, mail server, web server, file server. If the person who is connected here, this is the, for example, this is the mail server and this is the web server. Okay. So the client will access through this machine. This request goes to this machine. This will transfer to this. This will transfer to this, like this. So this machine will work like all these server. Got it or not? This is only the web server. This is only the file server. This is only the mail server. But when the client which is connected directly with this server, this server will act like all these four server: data server, mail server, web server, file server. Got it or not? Is that clear? I think this is very much clear. Subham, you are in doubt. Yes.
How to,
this is the networking. You know how to connect these
via router and like.
Yes, yeah, routers. We need routers, which is all these devices to connect all these.
But where is use the Hatchery Junior Server.
Everywhere the internet is working on this.
Nahin, how to use?
How to use? You want to know about implementation of this server?
Yes.
So we are doing only the cloud computing course. This is a different segment. I'll let you know about it later. How to configure this? You want to know about it? Okay. You want to know about it? How to configure it? They have some same configuration. No, different configuration. Different configuration. Different, totally different. Everything is different. All these machines are connected through routers. Okay, the DNS is working here. What the routers do, they will pass messages to other servers. Whenever we enter any information in Google browser, for example, www.gmail.com. So this request goes to ISP, internet service provider, routers. And yes, any question? Yes, Subham, you are asking some question? No. Okay, this request goes to the ISP. For example, I am using Airtel connection. I am using Jio connection. So what they are only ISP, internet service provider. This request goes to the particular ISP IP address. They have server. This request passed by the ISP to the specific server. And that this specific DNS server passed this message to the other domain controllers or other network devices through the routers. All of you know CCNA? Yes. What is in cloud computing? What I say everyone, before starting cloud computing, you should have idea, little bit idea about servers, little bit idea about networking, little bit idea about CCNA, little bit idea about operating system. This is required to understand cloud computing and grid. If you don't know what is topology, what type of cables are there, if you will say, sir, how we can connect these devices, what media we will use to connect these, what connector we will use to connect these devices, how these devices will connect to each other, if we will connect through the wireless media, what type of wireless media we will use, what standards are, multiple standards are there for the Ethernet standard 802.1.2.3.4.5.6. These are the Ethernet standards. And if we will discuss about wireless 802.11, 802.12, different standards are there. What is bottleneck? What is bandwidth? What is band rate? So when we are going to study about cloud computing, we should have idea about it. Sir, I'm aware. Subham. Good. Sudhanshu also. Sudhanshu. Yes, sir. Gulshan, you also know about it. Good. You need to do study, little bit study, how we can connect these devices. Here we can say that these four machines are connected in a mesh topology, not in mesh topology. We have to connect one single wire from this server to this server. This server will be in mesh topology. You know mesh topology? Every machine is directly connected to each other. Everyone. So here we have this machine is connected to this. 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 And this machine is connected to directly connected to this. But this machine is not directly connected to this. Got it? Got it? Yes. So is it clear what is homogeneous, what is heterogeneous? What is homogeneous, what is heterogeneous? Any doubt in that? You need to remember, you should keep in your mind, if we are connecting different operating machines, okay, and the machines are in different locations, database servers, mail server, web servers, so we will go with grid computing. Any doubt? No. So grid computing. Have a look on this picture. One is AD server, Active Directory server, domain controller, you can say that. You know domain controller? Backslide. That's okay. It's okay. This one.